Well, you know, I think Oscar DePriest is real genius lied in his ability to realize the potential of political organization efforts for African Americans in this country, not just in Chicago, but across the entire land. Skills as an organizer, he had been elected as Cook County Commissioner in 1904, and then again in 1906. Unfortunately, he had wound up on the wrong side of a political battle between Congressman Madden and a state senator named Sam Edelson in 1908. And Chicago politics can be very unforgiving. He found himself basically in political limbo at that time. You know, we were on the losing side of a political battle. You know, there can be consequences. So during this time, he just threw himself back into his real estate practice. But at the same time, he kept up efforts to maintain his personal constituency, if you will. I think he always had it in the back of his mind that he was going to return to politics. So Madden was the second ward committeeman on top of being a United States congressman. So when DePriest approached him in 1915 with his desire to be a city councilman in Chicago, he had the backing of 38 precinct captains, a large number of Baptist and Methodist clergymen, and a host of doctors, lawyers, innkeepers, and local businessmen. I mean, Madden was no fool. He understood what the demographics of the Second Ward were, which is primarily African American. So he threw his lot in behind DePriest for his run to be an alderman from the Second Ward. And there were four other candidates who were running against DePriest. And out of a total vote cast of 22,000, he got 10,600 of them. And just for the record, he financed his own campaign. There was no campaign contribution pool to draw from. He financed the whole thing with his own money. Long story short, he received the most votes, and on April 17th, 1915, he became the first black member of the Chicago City Council. To say the least, he was adored by the people in his ward. Every black person in Chicago all of a sudden had a level of hope they had never felt before. I mean, he instilled a profound sense of pride in all those black Chicagoans that they had never felt before. For the first time, they felt they could really make a change through the ballot box. I think it was a realization of that power that they had that really shaped the way things progressed between then and the time that he went to Congress in 1928. Not just in the black community, but I think in the white community also, the politicians realized that this man had his finger on a huge power base which could be used to their collective advantage, if you will.